The Fort Myers Police Department is making changes after allegations that officers tipped off drug dealers and cheated on exams.
Last year's Freeh Report dropped those bombshell allegations and others, including racism in the department. NBC2's Levi Ismail is in our studio with the changes that have been made.
Well, there were many recommendations, and in my first sit-down interview with Chief Derek Diggs, he was determined to meet them all. But his biggest priority was to make sure people could trust the police department again. Barbara Battles tells me she changed the way she now thinks about Fort Myers police.
I didn't want to call the police, but then I did.
One night she noticed someone prowling outside her window. A phone call later, and police arrived within minutes.
They finally came, and I told them what happened. They searched the area.
Barbara had no idea this substation was operational just down the block.
They did very well. So I said, my God, I'm saved.
One of 32 recommendations, this substation is an answer for how to rebuild fractured trust with FMPD.
They really haven't been friendly. I haven't talked to them.
1 year ago, I sat down with Chief Derek Diggs to ask what his plans were for a department being accused of racism, favoritism, and even officers tipping off drug dealers.
Similar to our audit, you know. It ain't gonna be all positive.
Since the interview, FMPD, to their credit, have acted on making several recommendations a reality. More cameras in high-crime neighborhoods is deterring criminals. They've also tied RICO charges to several gang members, keeping them off the streets.
We know the city is safer. We're starting to build relationships.
I am confident that we are way better today than we have been.
Five officers were put on leave shortly after the report, but to this day, only one was fired for something unrelated. A moot point for some who want to see more officers and more support. Fort Myers Police declined our interview today and declined to answer if any officers were still on leave. I did speak with the father of one of those officers earlier today, and he confirms his son is still on leave. In studio, Levi Ismail, NBC2.